Welcome students of class 6. Welcome to another mathematics lesson of which our topic is angles and lines. You have already been made aware of what angles are in your previous class of 5. You know what angles are, you know the basic geometrical concepts. So we shall straight dive in to what the first topic of this chapter will be. The first topic that is required will be the types of angles. We have the types of angles. So there are different types of angles, obviously. So what are the different types of angles? The first type that we are going to learn is a zero angle. Now, what is a zero angle? We take a straight line, x and y. Since this has no angle over it, so therefore this will be called a zero angle. It will have a measure of 0 degree only. Next. Now we slightly increase the value, but not too much. So therefore what we get an acute angle. What is an acute angle? O, X and Y. This angle such that it is lesser than 90 degree but greater than 0 degree. Such that it is greater than 0 degree but lesser than 90 degree, then such an angle will be called an acute angle. After we do an acute angle, we come to number 3, that is a right angle. So what is a right angle? An angle which has a measure of 90 degree, is called a right angle. Now, right angle is denoted by this sign. So, therefore, angle YOX equal to 90 degree will be the right angle. Number 4 is the obtuse angle. Number 4 will be the obtuse angle. What is an obtuse angle? O, Y, X. An angular measurement, say angle Y, O, X, when it is lesser than 180 degree but it is greater than 90 degree. Such an angular measurement will be called an obtuse angle. What will it be called? It will be called an obtuse angle. The next, number 5. We have what we call a straight angle. What is a straight angle? A straight angle. We select a point on the line xy. The angle on the upper half or the lower half, a semicircular looking angle of measure 180 degree will be called a straight angle. So therefore angle xoy is equal to 180 degree is called the straight angle. Number 6, we have the reflex angle. What is the reflex angle? Reflex angle is, say this point is O, this point is X and this point is Y. We have this angle is called the reflex angle. So therefore any angle which is greater than 180 degree but lesser than 360 degree is called the reflex angle. The last angle that we need to know is the complete angle or the whole angle. That is a very important part. We have the whole angle or it is called the complete angle. What is the whole angle or the complete angle? We take a point, just a single point, and the whole angle around itself is 360 degree. So therefore any whole angle is called a 360 degree. How do we show it? It will be better to show. Say we have a ray starting at O and this is A. The angle around this point is 360 degree and called a whole or a complete angle. I hope you have understood the different types of angles. is required in our syllabus. Okay, now classifications of your different types of angles will be found in your books. I hope you will go through the examples. Okay, so now the different other types of angles. This should be our last topic for this lesson. What are the different other types of angles? We have complementary angles. We have complementary angles. Now the spellings are very important, even though this is not English, but it is very important. C-O-M-P-L-E-M-E-N-T-A-R-Y. But what is C-O-M-P-L-I-M-E-N-T-R-Y? Compliment means to praise someone. But this complementary angle means, what you have to remember, complementary angles are a pair of angles. There are two angles, say angle ABC and say angle DEF. These will be called two complementary angles when angle ABC plus angle DEF equal to 90 degrees. That is a right angle. Okay? Angle ABC plus angle DEF equal to 90 degrees. When the addition of two angles will give rise to 90 degrees, these two angles will be called as complementary angles. Similarly, we have supplementary angles. Now, what are supplementary angles? Again, it is a pair of angles such that those two angles add up to 180 degrees. In that case, these two angles as a pair will be called supplementary angles. So when two angles add up to 90 degrees, they are called complementary angles. When two angles add up to 180 degrees, they are called supplementary angles. I hope you have understood till this part. I hope this is clear. So what are complementary and supplementary angles? Complementary angles are those which consist of a pair of angles which add up to 90 degrees, and supplementary angles are those which consist of a pair which add up to 180 degrees. Okay, practice these exercises back at home. I hope you are understanding and enjoying the chapter. This is a chapter of geometry, and this will be included in your half yearly syllabus. So practice well at home. Thank you, students.